So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's class, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 6th to 8th of January 2023. And I hope your preparations for the upcoming RBI Grade B exam are going well. And please, abhi delay hone ki zarurat nahi hai. Just gear up yourself for preparation. And yeah, exam jo hai wo aisa umeed hai ki first वीक ऑफ अप्रैल में फेज वन हो जाएगा. सो यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट द नोटिफिकेशन आइदर इन द मंथ ऑफ आइदर इन द एंड ऑफ फेब्रुअरी और इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ मार्च. ऑलराइट, सो ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट फॉर द प्रिपरेशन. लेट्स स्टार्ट विद टुडेस सेशन विद वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच इज अबाउट प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट अ क्वेश्चन आइदर इन फेज वन और इन फेज टू. सो प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस कन्वेंशन इज द फ्लैगशिप इवेंट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट अबाउट दिस. 17th edition of Pravasi Bharatiya Divas Convention took taking place in the year 2023. So let's talk about Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. Now first of all, and question number 2 is also based on the same news. The Pravasi Bharatiya Divas, why it is being observed? So it is observed to celebrate the returning of Mahatma Gandhi to India in the year 1915. 1915 mein Gandhi ji laut ke Bharat aaye the wapas. इसके लिए इस डे को सेलिब्रेट किया जाता है प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस और डायस्पोरा डे. राइट, सो दिस वाज द 17th प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस कन्वेंशन विच टुक प्लेस. एक्चुअली इट इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन पार्टनरशिप विद मध्य प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट इन इंदौर. राइट, सो यू शुड रिमेंबर द लोकेशन एज वेल वेयर इट इज टेकिंग प्लेस. इट इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन इंदौर. राइट, इट प्रोवाइड्स एन इंपॉर्टेंट प्लेटफॉर्म to engage. Right, it provides an important platform to engage and connect with the overseas Indian and to enable the diaspora to interact with each other. So basically it provides a platform to the overseas Indian so that they can interact with each other. All right, now the theme for the year 2023 is Diaspora, Reliable Partners for India's Progress in Amrit Kal. Now we are in the period of Amrit Kal, that is from India's 75 year of independence to India's 100th year of independence, that is we are calling as Amrit Kal. So this theme is also based on the Amrit Kal. Okay, now talking more about this convention, so it is this time it is very much significance because after a gap of 4 years it is being organized as a physical event. Last time in the year 2021 this convention took place वर्चुअली. ये जो कन्वेंशन था वर्चुअली हुआ था, तो 4 सालों के बाद फिजिकल मोड में हो रहा है. देन दैट इज व्हाई इट होल्ड्स मच सिग्निफिकेंस. राइट, नाउ देयर आर 3 सेगमेंट्स ऑफ दिस कन्वेंशन. नंबर 1 इज यूथ प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस. यूथ प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस विच विल बी ऑर्गेनाइज इन पार्टनरशिप विद मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ यूथ अफेयर्स एंड स्पोर्ट विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर अनुराग सिंह ठाकुर. एंड इन दिस यूथ प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस कन्वेंशन जेनेटा मैस्करेनस हु इज द मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट ऑस्ट्रेलिया विल बी द चीफ गेस्ट. राइट, देन सेकेंड इज प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस कन्वेंशन विच विल बी इनॉग्रेटेड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी. इट विल ऑल्सो फीचर एड्रेसेस बाय चीफ गेस्ट डॉक्टर मोहम्मद इरफान अली हु इज द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ गयाना. एंड देर विल बी स्पेशल गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर चंद्रिका प्रसाद संतोखी हु इज द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ सुरीनाम. Alright, and number 3 is Pravasi Bharatiya Samman Awards 2023. These awards will be given to those overseas Indians who have done exceptionally well in various fields, right? Either in India or abroad. ठीक है? And now talking about the 5 thematic plenary sessions of this convention. 5 thematic convention होंगे. Number 1 is for the role of diaspora youth in innovation and technologies. Right, number 1 will be focused on the youth. Right, role of Indian diaspora in promoting Indian healthcare ecosystem in Amrit Kal. It will be chaired by Union Health Minister Dr. Mansukh Mandavia. Leveraging the soft power of India, goodwill through craft, cuisine and creativity. All right, and it will be chaired by Minister of State for External Affairs Meenakshi Lekhi. Then number 4, enabling global mobility of Indian workforce, which will be organized by the Ministry of Skill Development, and of course it will be chaired by the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship Dharmendra Pradhan. And finally, harnessing the potential of diaspora entrepreneurs towards an inclusive approach to nation building. Now you don't have to, you know, in sabko bahut zyada ratne ki zarurat nahi hai. You don't have to remember everything. You can just give 2 or 3 reads to these 5 thematic sessions, तो आपको exam में recall हो जाएगा. You would be able to recall during the examination. ठीक है? एंड देन अ पोस्टल स्टैम्प, अ कमेमोरेटिव पोस्टल स्टैम्प विल बी रिलीज विच इज टाइटल्ड एज सुरक्षित जाए प्रशिक्षित जाए, राइट? सुरक्षित जाए प्रशिक्षित जाए इज द टाइटल ऑफ दिस कमेमोरेटिव स्टैम्प एंड इट विल बी रिलीज टू अंडरलाइन द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ सेफ लीगल एंड ऑर्डरली माइग्रेशन. ऑलराइट, एंड फर्स्ट एवर डिजिटल प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस एग्जीबिशन विल ऑल्सो बी इनॉग्रेटेड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी टू हाईलाइट द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ डायस्पोरा फ्रीडम फाइटर्स इन इंडियाज इंडिपेंडेंस. जो डायस्पोरा फ्रीडम फाइटर्स है उनका क्या कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन है इन इंडियाज इंडिपेंडेंस, उसको प्रेजेंट करने के लिए दिस एग्जीबिशन विल बी इनॉग्रेटेड बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी. एंड दिस एग्जीबिशन विल हैव दिस थीम आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ डायस्पोरा इन इंडियन फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल. नाउ प्लीज डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज बिटवीन द थीम्स. दिस थीम इज फॉर डिजिटल प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस एग्जीबिशन एंड दैट विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर दैट इज फॉर ओवरऑल प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस कन्वेंशन. ठीक है, आई होप प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस इज क्लियर एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 and 2. So you have to identify incorrect statement. It has been organized in partnership with Maharashtra government in Nagpur. No, it has been organized in partnership with Madhya Pradesh government in Indore. Its theme is Diaspora, Reliable Partners for India's Progress in Amrit Kal. Absolutely correct, no problem. It is being organized as a physical event after a gap of 4 years and first after the onset of COVID-19 pandemic. Ye bhi baat sahi hai. First ever digital PVD exhibition will be held to highlight the contribution of diaspora freedom fighters in India's independence. Correct. So this must be incorrect. Youth Pravasi Bharati Divas is one of the 3 segments of this convention with President of Suriname, Chandika Prasad Santokhi, a special guest of honor. No. In Youth Pravasi Bharati Divas, the special guest of honor is Mr. Mascarenhas, who is the Member of Parliament of Australia. I know, thoda sa ye deep ho gaya question, but yes, you never know, RBI bhi kuch aisa hi question pooch le. Right, so the correct answer will be option. We have to identify incorrect statement. 1 and 5 are incorrect, which means option D. Option D is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 2, which is based on the same news. A commemorative postal stamp was released during this convention to underline the importance of safe, legal, orderly and skilled migration. What is the title of this postal stamp? Very easy. Surakshit Jaye, Prashikshit Jaye is the title. Option C is the correct answer. Alright. And now let's talk about question number 3. I hope Pravasi Bharatiya Divas is clear. This is question number 3. Which ministry is organizing Startup India Innovation Week 2023 to celebrate the Indian startup ecosystem as well as National Startup Day, which will be observed on 16th of January. Right. Last year, agar aapko yaad ho, to Prime Minister announced that 16th January will be celebrated as National Startup Day. So to celebrate the National Startup Day and to celebrate the Indian startup ecosystem, this Startup Innovation Week is being organized by Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. And may I know under which ministry this department works? Come on, tell me. It works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. Right? So option D will be the correct answer. Okay, now talking about the broader objective of this Innovation Week. So it will engage the startup ecosystem stakeholders across the nation and spur the spirit of entrepreneurship and innovation in India. Ab ye bhi again, you don't have to remember these things word to word. You just have to understand that why this Innovation Week is being organized. Right? And I hope that is clear. So the correct answer is Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Question number 4, very, very important question. President Draupadi Murmu gave away the Digital India Awards 2022 to the winners. You have to identify the incorrect statement about Digital India Award. Right? This question ke option next page pe hai. So please, kyunki yahan pe jagah nahi bach rahi thi, so I have put it here. So please remember, question number 4, the options are on the next slide. Right? Now let's talk about Digital India Awards first and then we will move on to the winners of the year 2022. So the objective of Digital India Award is to encourage and honor the innovative digital ideas of the government entities, honor the innovative digital solutions or initiatives by the government entities only. There is no inclusion of private sector here, right? At all levels in the realm of digital governance. For the very first time, it was launched in the year 2009 and the nodal agency to give away to decide the awards is the National Informatics Center, which works under the Ministry of Electronics and IT, headed by Ashwini Vaishnav. Okay. Now, what is the selection process? So, first of all, the initiative, जो भी इनिशिएटिव नॉमिनेट होना चाहता है, that has to file the nomination through राष्ट्रीय पुरस्कार पोर्टल, which was launched some time back. I think few months back, this राष्ट्रीय पुरस्कार पोर्टल was launched to invite nomination regarding all the awards जो भी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया देती है, ठीक है? This is followed by ranking of entries by nomination processing partner. Now, who is the nomination processing partner here? It is IIT Delhi. IIT Delhi, and finally the winners are selected by a jury. Okay, and the eligible entities are all central or state government ministries, all departments, offices, organization, district administration, and Indian missions abroad. So everything in the government sector is everybody, every organization in the government sector is an eligible entity to get these awards. Okay, now the awards for the year 2022 have been given in the 7 categories. Number 1 is the digital empowerment of citizens. So platinum award was awarded to ENAM, which is of course under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Gold, transport mission mode project of Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Silver award was given to judgment search portal of Supreme Court of India. Okay, now you have to remember all three. In all the 7 categories, you have to remember the all the awards. Okay, I can't do anything because these days they are going, you know, बहुत ज़्यादा deep में questions पूछे जा रहे हैं, तो I can't help in it. You have to remember it. But yes, you don't have to remember in a single day or within 15 minutes or half an hour. You can do continuous revision. तो बार बार जब आप revision करते रहोगे तो you will be able to remember these things. Second category is digital initiatives at grassroots level. The platinum award was given to e-Vivechana app of Madhya Pradesh. Remember, the question can also be asked in the form like, in the digital initiatives at grassroots level category, the platinum award was given to e-Vivechana app of which state government? Okay, so it is the Madhya Pradesh government's app, right? Gold award was given to DEGS, Computer Basic Training of Jharkhand. And silver award was given to Shirashri portal of Kerala, right? The third category is digital initiatives for ease of doing business. The platinum was given to Mine Mitra of Uttar Pradesh. Gold was given to E-Abkari of Odisha. And silver was given to Invest Punjab of course, Punjab. ठीक है? आगे चलते हैं. In the next category, which is data sharing and use for socio-economic development, the platinum award is given to Smart Cities Mission of Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. The gold award is given to CBSC, and silver is Center for E-Governance of Karnataka Government. ठीक है? Next category पे आ जाते हैं. One second, yeah. Next category है public digital platforms, and the awards are divided into two sub-categories again. One is the states category and one is the central ministries or departments category, right? So states mein platinum award was given to Dware Sarkar of West Bengal, and gold award was given to e-services Manipur of Manipur government. In the central ministries or department, it is IceGate portal of Ministry of Finance which has got the platinum award, and the gold award was awarded to e-shram of the Ministry of Labour and Employment. Theek hai? Let's move ahead then to the next category, which is digital initiatives and collaboration with startup. Platinum award was given to Digital Workforce Management System of Kerala. Gold was given to Smart Nutrient Management of the Soil of Telangana government. And silver was given to Digital Deposit Refund Scheme of Uttarakhand government. Theek hai ji? So these were the sixth and now this is the seventh category. Best Web and Mobile Initiative, Platinum, Bilaspur District website of Chhattisgarh. Gold, website of Kottayam District of Kerala. And silver was given to website of CIPET, which is Central Institute of Petrochemical Engineering and Technology, which is under the Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers. Okay? So I think these were the seven categories under which the awards have been given. I hope this is clear. Now you have to identify incorrect statement. The awards were instituted in 2009 by NIC, MIT under, yes, correct. Both central or state government departments, entities, etc. and private sector. Is that so? private sectors are not eligible entities to get these awards. Okay? Please remember it. ENAM was awarded Platinum Award in Digital Empowerment of Citizens. Correct. Smart Nutrient Management of the Soil Telangana was awarded Platinum Award. No, the Platinum was given to the initiative of Kerala. The Telangana government's initiative was awarded with the Gold Award. Okay? And Ishram was awarded Platinum Award in Public Digital Platforms. No, in Public Digital Platform, the Platinum, I believe, was given to IceGate. And Ishram was awarded again with Gold. Okay? So, incorrect statement nikalni hai hame 2, 4 and 5. Alright? 2, 4 and 5. Option C is the correct answer. I hope this question is also clear. Let's move ahead to question number, whatever it is. Question number 5. Which ministry has launched an online invitation management portal which is named as Amantran portal? Amantran in English means invitation only. To extend e-invitation to dignitaries or guests and online sale of tickets to general public for witnessing Republic Day and Independence Day events. So, this is very easy. Ho gaya hai ab. Now, through this portal, the Ministry of Defense will extend the e-invitation to the dignitaries who will be the guest of honor at the Republic Day or the Independence Day events. And also, the online sale of tickets to general public who wants to go for these events. Right, so the correct answer is Ministry of Defense headed by Mr. Rajnath Singh. Now, baki isme aur kuch important nahi hai, but you can have a, you can give a quick read to these lines through the PDF. Question number 6, Aspirational Block Program has finally been launched by the Prime Minister Modi. However, much details have not been provided by the government, but definitely details aayengi bahut jald. Abhi ke liye bas launch hua hai, it was announced in this year's budget. In this year's Union Budget 2020-23 mein isko announce kiya gaya tha and now it has been launched. The question is how many districts will be covered initially under it. So, jo preliminary information hai uske hisab se, this aspirational block program will cover 500 districts across 31 states or UTs initially. Alright. Now, where this program was launched during the second National Conference of Chief Secretaries and of course, the Aspirational Blocks Program, what is the objective? So, it is on the lines of Aspirational Districts Program under which the potential districts which have the potential of development are being developed by the Government of India. Similarly, the objective is to improve performance of blocks lagging on various developmental parameters. And these are those blocks which have that potential of development but they are lagging behind due to certain reasons. Okay? Now, over half of these blocks are in 6 states, which are in Uttar Pradesh 68 blocks, Bihar 61, Madhya Pradesh 42, Jharkhand 34, Odisha 29 and West Bengal 29. So, you can say the highest number of blocks are in Uttar Pradesh, which is 68. Okay? So, abhi ke liye itni hi information available hai. So, we will discuss it later on, jab aur information aa jayegi. So, how many districts will it cover? 500, option E is the correct answer in 31 states or UTs across the country. Question number 7 pe aane se pehle main aapko ye bata dun, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join this Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. And if you want to ask anything related to examination, you can follow me here. Theek hai? Chalo ji, question number 7 pe aajate hain ab. Where has Indian Army deployed its largest contingent of women peacekeepers in United Nations mission to provide relief and assistance to women and children? So it was deployed in Abe. Abe is the disputed region between Sudan and South Sudan. Ye disputed region hai South Sudan ka aur Sudan ka. Theek hai, to option A is the correct answer. Where was astro-tourism event organized by National Council of Science Museum in association with Nehru Memorial Museum and Library? So it was organized in the capital New Delhi. Very straightforward and very easy question. There is no need of details of this, of such news. Okay? So New Delhi is the correct answer. And the last question for today. Talcher Fertilizer Project will be India's largest and the very first coal gasification plant that will become functional by October 2024. So in which state this plant is located? So do you know that Talcher is located in Odisha? And yes, this plant is also located in Odisha. So option A is the correct answer. Okay? All right, so that's it for today's session. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.